Otherwise, I wouldn't have let you look at it. It's just a piece of rope like you'd find in any bedroom. It's not in the rope. It's in a special knot that magicians have kept secret for hundreds of years called the Mongolian pop knot. I'm going to teach you step by step how to tie this ancient and venerable knot. The first step is to measure the rope carefully. You want to make sure that when you cut, you get two pieces of rope exactly the same length. Tie a Mongolian pop knot. Here's how it's tied. Take one rope, twist around the other rope like this, come back over this way, come around, come through, and pull tight. You go back and forth the same way as you went in and out, and then you go in and out at the same time as you went back and forth. You twist, come around, and pull tight. You have one Mongolian pop knot. Is everybody with me so far?
Right.
At this point, you simply reach in your pocket, you take some magic pixie dust.
Oh.
Pixie dust. You sprinkle the pixie dust on the knot like so. Okay? Now, in a few seconds, that pixie dust will cause the knot to dissolve and pop right out of the Some of you may have had a hard time seeing exactly how to tie that knot, especially those of you in the cheaper seats. So I'm going to do this again. This time we'll cut the rope into three even pieces. This gives you twice as much chance to see how the knot is tied, because it takes two Mongolian pop knots in order to put three pieces of rope back together again. Am I going too fast? Because that very seldom happens. Remember, when you try this at home, folks, make sure you cut all three ropes exactly the same length. If you make a mistake here, the trick's not going to work. You want to get all three pieces of rope exactly the same length. If you make a mistake, the trick won't work. For example, if instead of cutting three ropes all this, the same length, you would make a mistake and get one of the ropes just a little bit short, trick. The trick won't work. If you get one rope about right and the other rope too long. Well, this can happen to anybody. So, if it happens to you, there is a way out. As long as I'm teaching you the trick, I'll teach you what we magicians call a contingency plan. You make a mistake cutting the ropes, you fold them over one at a time, like this, short, medium, and long, and you say the magic words, sim salamin. You have to say these with a certain amount of conviction. Sin. Salivate. Oh, see, it worked. Did that cause the ropes to stretch? Add stretch, add stretch.
What?
Maybe you weren't sorry for him. But I know. Okay. Now back to the Mongolian pop knot. We take rope number one, rope number two. I'm going to tie these together. Watch closely. I'll go slow. You take one rope, twist it around the other rope like this. Come back over this way. Come around. Come through, and pull tight. You go back and forth the same way as you went in and out. And then you go in and out at the same time as you went back and forth. Fish, come around, and pull tight. you have two Mongolian pop. Well, no, that's one. That's one. The second one's tied the same way.
I got ahead of myself. That was just like,
second one's tied the same way. You take one rope, twist it around the other rope like this, come back over this way, come around, come through, and pull tight. You go back and forth the same way as you went in and out, and then you go in and out at the same time as you went back and forth to twist, come around and pull tight. You have two Mongolian pop knots. Everybody with me so far? Good. At this point, you simply reach in your pocket, you take some magic pixie dust. That's very good. That's very studious. You sprinkle the pixie dust on the knots like so. Any questions so far? What?
What's in the pixie
dust? Pixies. I grind my own. Not just for economy, for purity. I'd send the kids out of the house because pixies make a heck of a noise. And be distressing for the very young. In a few seconds, pixie dust will cause a nice